So what is going on with all of the businesses on the east side of Statesville? There's so many of them that are closing, and this one is about ready to close. This is the Signal Hill Mall in Statesville, North Carolina, and I'm going to take a closer look at this today, give you a little bit of the history, take a drive around it, we're going to take a walk inside it, and then you let me know what you think. Is it progress or is it failure? So welcome to the Signal Hill Mall in Statesville, North Carolina, or as I lovingly call it, the non-mall, which you will soon find out why. We're going to cruise around the outside of this so I can show you some of the stores that were here and give you a little bit of the history before we go on the inside. And as you'll see, we'll be able to, we're going to have to go around the carnival that is here right now, set up in the mall. I was here Friday night and there were probably more cars in this parking lot that have been here for years. Most I've seen since we had the fireworks display here. But let's take a cruise around so you can see. So the original developer of this mall was C&J Associates. And they built the small strip mall next door, the Newtown Plaza. That's one of the ones that we're going to take a look at in a later video, because it also is in trouble. This here is the old Sears store. I don't know that you can still see anything on the outside of the building. You cannot. So we're going to drive around the back side and we will stop and take a little chat. I gotta maneuver around all of the carnival trailers and everything that are here actually blocking it, so we're gonna take a little pause. Okay, I'm on the back side of the mall now because we are blocked by all of the carnival things. This was the old Winn-Dixie at the back of the mall. Wanted to get a shot of this because we're gonna talk about this. It's part of the history. It's actually detached from the mall and has been closed for a very long time. And then this is the back side of the Sears that we saw at the front. And over on this side is the JCPenney. And you can see way back in that little corner there is the community police center that used to be tucked into the mall and made a part of it. This was the back door of the Sears here and the JCPenney's. We'll cruise around a little bit more and take another look at what's happening with this mall, which is really nothing. So it was developed, as I said, by CJ and Associates. And they built the strip mall, Newtown Plaza, which is just below this mall here. They built that one back in the 1960s. And at the same time, that's when I-77 was also being built. And they knew that the growth was definitely coming out to the highway. The sprawl was gonna happen, as in any other town that has happened. You can see all of the writings. Now this was the Peebles. I'm gonna stop a little bit here and tell you a little bit about the history why we're sitting right here. So when the sprawl came out into this side of town and they decided they were going to expand, there was a farm here. It was the Bowles farm, and he had horses on a big field here where the mall currently sits, and had a very large home that actually sits behind this mall. I'm gonna try and sneak a peek of it. However, there was a picture last night that the house actually caught fire, which is very sad. The owners of this mall also own that property. They purchased it in 2001 for $1 million. And it burnt last night. I don't know how badly it burnt, but I'm gonna try and get a picture of it and I'll show you a a before and after. There have been some other videos on that house. They call it the creepy house of Statesville because it's just been abandoned for so long. But there's been several videos made of people that have been going through it and checking out the house. So you can, I'll link to that in the description below so that you can check that out also. So they did purchase that land and began the mall. They had plans of it in 1971. And in August of 1973, the Signal Hill Mall opened with 250,000 square feet of space anchored by Belk, which you can see right over there, which is the only anchor that is still open today in this mall. The road in front of the mall was called Signal Hill, and that was named by a radio station that was here that had their tower out here on the road. Therefore, they called it Signal Hill. When I moved here, I always thought it was because of all the traffic lights on the hill, because there's a bunch of them, but guess I was wrong. By 1988, the mall had added the fourth wing, which was the JCPenney's that we saw. So this Peebles wing was here originally. And then they had the Winn-Dixie store also that was at the back of the community, back of the mall, along with the community police station. Woolworths, which was where the Sears was originally, then became a Hills department store, and then it became the Sears in 1994. And this one here, where the Peebles is, was Spain Hours, and then Peebles came in here and then closed in the early 2000s. That was right after I had moved here. I actually moved here in 1997, so that was still open when I was here. JCPenney, they closed in 2015, leaving Belk over here as the only anchor store left in the mall, and it is still standing. So what happened to this mall? Let's take a look inside, and I'll show you the four remaining stores that are left in there, and it's gonna take you back through time because this mall has not changed since 1973. It's pretty much the same. This down below, that is the Newtown Plaza. I'm going to drive around front because we're going to go inside. This is the Newtown Plaza also that you can sneak down. They're actually connected by a road right there. And there used to be a miniature golf place in the back of that mall down there. And that was JR's Tobacco that had billboards all up and down the highway. For those of you that remember it. Cheap cigarettes, cheap perfume, lots of souvenirs. It was a destination place. People stopped there all the time to shop. But this is the back of the Belk, which is still open. Yeah, speed bumps. Why, I don't know, because there's really no traffic here anymore. There's not much happening here at the mall. And then we'll come back around to the front of the mall. And across the street, you can see there, that's going to be in the other video too. That used to be the Kmart Plaza over there. And that also has recently closed. We're going to take a closer look at all of those in a later video. Still have the Wells Fargo here and AT&T store. And then the Belk, which is only accessible actually from out here. You cannot access the Belk store from inside the mall anymore. They have that blocked off. So I'm just gonna park and we're gonna go take a walk inside. You can see the old market and deli that used to be JD's, but that has since closed up. So the International House of Pancakes right there is one of the only ones, only restaurant in the mall that is still open. And that's been there for a very long time. So let's go take a peek.
All right, so here we are at the front of the mall. You can see very little has changed since the 1970s. The front entrance is still the same as it always was. Let's go peek inside this mall. I think you're gonna love it. There's been plenty of videos made of it, and I wanted to document it before it was gone. Like I said, there were only four businesses left in the mall. That's JD's Deli, Longo. It was a barbecue restaurant before it was JD's. And then this is a nail salon, and it used to be a hair salon because I used to get my hair done there. And of course the IHOP, which is also closed from inside the mall. All of the original planters are still in here, and they still have live plants, which is very cool. And you can hear the music playing. It's kind of odd. Okay, so that's where we came in. And then down this way is where the Sears was. That was an alterations place right there. M Alterations. Oops, let me get my camera straightened back up again. I love all this old music. It's kind of fun walking through here listening to that. So you can see down at this end, there's nothing open down here. Everything is all closed. This is where Sears was, which was, again, Hills, and then originally Woolworths. Everybody remember those Woolworths stores? I sure do. That tell my age? Ooh. Now the entrance. And like I said, you can see the damage on these stores. There's so much damage in here that they're... This could not be restored. Take a lot to restore this place. So right out here, I remember, was KB Toys, because of course all my kids had to go there all the time. And there was a shoe store right out here. I can't remember if it was Payless. You have the Artist Guild of Statesville here, which was a gallery, but that's gone. But we do have a piano place right here that is still in business. Closed right now because the store mall hours are not open yet, but Jack's Furniture and Piano Restoration is still there with his pianos in there. Now this is fun. Look at these guys. Now there's some old school. And on this corner used to be a jewelry store, but I believe they're closed right now too. All right, you still have Wooten Jewelers on the corner. They have been here forever. Still hanging in there too. Now this is the wing. Merle Norman is right there, but they have all moved downtown now. They have a shop down there, and you can see this little seating area right here. That's exactly what it was a seating area, because if you can see where the tiles, where the red and white are there, well, you can guess it. That used to be a Chick-fil-A restaurant right there when I first moved here. First time I ever had Chick-fil-A too. It's absolutely delicious. I still love Chick-fil-A, but they had this little tiny seating area right up here with a few chairs up here so you could hang out. And then there were several other little stores all down through here. I can remember a Claire's was in here at one time. It was a music store. There it was, Amada. Again, all gone. Let's see. Stars Wireless. Now that one looks like it's still in business, that little cell phone store right there. Everything else is closed. That one, Lerner. It said Lerner up there, but I remember when this was the Iredell Children's Play Place. They had all kinds of little things in there for kids to do and little play areas where the parents could bring them and while they were shopping. And then we're down here by JCPenney. So there's the JCPenney, all still closed. And then over here, on this wing over here, was where the Peebles Stain Hours was. So that was part of the original wing. There's a little alleyway down that way. And this stage right here always had local entertainment happening on it. Whether it was kids or it was adults playing music of some sort, there was always something going on this end of the mall. Now they've got the, unfortunately, they've got the little fountains off. There's three of them in this mall, but this one's turned off right now and hasn't been on in a long while. But some of the old videos that you'll see of people going through the mall had the, they were still on at that time. Hi, how are you? I just had to stop for a minute. I had a lovely conversation from an elderly lady that has been walking this mall since 2000. She's very disappointed that this indoor mall will probably end up going away, as are a lot of people. We would love to see it stay here and get renovated and updated with some new stores and new restaurants. And I still don't think retail is dead, but I could be wrong. But she said that there is also an adult community behind here, and she felt like that was the reason that they located the King's Grant community there, so that the elderly could come in here and walk this mall on a daily basis. But that has all been changed. So we're back to the Merle Norman again, which I said is downtown now. You can see we've got some caution places on the floor in here where the tiles have been removed. It's definitely in disrepair. This is the center fountain here that usually is running. Still got water in it, so they just have it off for today, but it is actually still functional and has has money in it. I think money's been in there for a very long time. But this little fountain is usually going. Oh, there's our mall walkers. So there you have Saslow's Jewelers. That one had been there for a very long time too, but they are also gone. You see the NBA emblem there. Fan Shop is what that one says. And I remember there was a little seasonal place right here. I always had different things in there, and I can remember at one time the schools had the kids artwork displayed there so that you could come in and check it out. We have some other stores here. Now my favorite store in the mall was right here, and that was Bookland. I love a good bookstore. I was really sad when this one closed. Nothing left in there but some of the counters. Hard to see. And I think that this was one of those Hickory Farm places years ago. I can't be sure, but the outside sure looks like it was one of those. And of course, here's the Belk, and you can see that it is, get you crazy here, closed from the outside. Can't go in there from here. I don't know why they closed it off. I guess because the mall is just unsafe. And I don't remember what this little barn was. And the lady that I was talking to was telling me, and I didn't really realize that, there's an alleyway to go outside. One of the problems with this mall was there was never a public bathroom in here. You could go inside the stores and use the restrooms, but they did not have just a public one inside the mall itself. So that probably was a mistake right from the beginning. There the old Radio Shack was. Ooh, that sounded weird. I'm walking on that carpet in it. It's making some very weird sounds. And this store right here was the last casualty so far. This was the Bath and Body Works. Still see it a little bit up on the top there. And this store has closed. They are now over by the Walmart Plaza. Just moved in over there just a couple of weeks ago. So let's see. So part of the story went that in 2004, they had plans that they had laid out for this mall to give it a facelift, modernize it, and then 2007 recession hit. And there went those plans, as well as a lot of other plans for a lot of other people. That was a devastating time. Owners stopped taking any leases in preparation for the renovations. And by doing that, it really hurt a lot of the large stores, especially Peebles. That was pretty much the nail in the coffin for Peebles and the Winn-Dixie. They closed at that time when they no longer renewed the leases. And then we were told that in 2013, they tried to, there goes somebody that's a, that's an actual store owner in here, getting ready to open up for the day. In 2013, there was talk that the developer had interest in doing some renovations in here. And in 2016, Bob Collier, who is one of the owners, had actually done an interview with WSIC, one of the local radio stations, and said that the mall would look something like Burkdale Village, which is a mixed-use development in Cornelius, just south of here, that's beautiful. It has retail shops, theaters, restaurants, housing up above it, just kind of a really cool place to hang. But that has not happened, as you can see. We are still looking pretty sad, and I think it's probably seen its last days. So I hope you have enjoyed your tour of this little mall, which actually, if you think about it, it's pretty amazing that Statesville, this tiny little town that we live in, it's really not that large, actually even had an enclosed mall to begin with in the 1970s. Old telephone booths. You know, you was usually reserved for your larger cities like Winston-Salem, which still has a mall there, and Charlotte, which has several malls, and Hickory, which still has a mall there. But Statesville had its own little mall for a very long time that was very vibrant and successful. And over time, it just took its toll. Now, whether it was mistakes made by the owners or if it was just progress in general, I don't know. I always thought because of the I-77 highway there, we were right at the crossroads of everything that was happening in this area, and really thought that there was a better future for this mall, but that did not happen. So my fingers are crossed that we are gonna see something fantastic happen between this mall and the one next door, the Newtown Plaza, that I'll talk about a little bit later. And hopefully we will see something that will last a very long time here. So I hope you enjoyed that tour. One of the things that I wanted to mention why I was in there and forgot was that part of the failure of this mall was because of the kind of bad feelings from the people from the downtown area when all of this sprawl happened and all of this movement out here with the new malls happened. There was a little bit of bad vibes going on because it was taking the people away from the downtown area, which was very vibrant at that time. And it suffered. There were a lot of closings in the downtown area due to that. And it's kind of ironic now because now we have a beautiful downtown area that has been completely renovated. And you can watch my tour on this video card of the downtown area that I did and see how beautiful it is down there. So it's kind of flip-flop now. The business has gone back downtown again, and kind of hurting this area now. So you just never know what is going to happen in a city when times change, and you just have to kind of go with that. So I would really love to see both of them come back to life. Beautiful downtown area, vibrant there, which has a completely different feel than it does out here, and then have another area out here that would bring people here, maybe for kids, some type of a amusement area for them so that they can have some activities, because there's certainly not enough of that around this town for our youth in here. So fingers crossed something great is going to happen. So I was able to sneak out to where the old Bowles Mansion was, right behind the mall. That's what burnt last night. Not completely burnt out, looks like they got it out, but something burnt out up there. Of course, there have been vagrants that have been living in this house for years. All kinds of stuff going on in there, I'm sure. Drugs and everything else, you name it. It is pretty creepy out here, though. But you can see this was once probably a beautiful, beautiful house. There's the mall right through there. That would be the back of the where was the Winn-Dixie. I'll just take a little cruise around this house. I'm really kind of surprised that they haven't. Sorry about the bouncing on this, because I'm walking on steady land, but I'm surprised they haven't torn this down yet. It's just kind of a open calling card for people to just come out and hang and get hurt. Look at these stairs. I'm gonna get over here on the road. There is actually a little driveway. There was a road coming in here at one time, but it's all kind of been blocked off, so you can't really drive out here anymore. Came in from Signal Hill Extension out there. So there's the mall. Peebles, looking at the back of Peebles and Belk, where we just were. And look at the front of this house. Oh my gosh, I can just imagine this house in better days. It was beautiful. I'm not going in because, well, I'm just not that brave. But I did want to get a shot of the outside, because more than likely this one's going to be gone too. Look at the detail on some of these columns on here. Oh my goodness, architects would love to get a hold of this stuff. All these arches on the bottom. I mean, the whole inside has just been knocked out, and people have just destroyed this thing. Even this tree, look at this magnolia. It's old. All of the vines have overgrown it. But look at that, stairs on both sides. What a beauty.